Hi, my name's Nick. I've been at Teen Challenge for 3 months, roughly. And Teen Challenge is a recovery center for addictions and life-controlling issues. And since I've been here, it's just been a great environment to get my life back.
Hello, my name is Jonathan Vincent. I am a student in the Teen Challenge program. I have been here for just over 12 months now.
So our schedule here at Teen Challenge is kind of designed to constantly keep us busy. So in the morning, say on like a weekday, we usually wake up at around 6 o'clock is actually our wake up time. From there, we have devotions, morning devotions at 6:30.
My name's Justin. I've been an addict since I've been 12 years old. Been in and out of jail my whole life, and I've given myself to Christ about a year ago, and I've been free ever since. And being here at Teen Challenge, it just gives me the opportunity to grow close to God.
I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust.
The reason for me getting into this stuff, I had a lot of hurt and pain from my past. Having the drugs was a way to escape from that state of mind. I started getting into snorting cocaine off and on, crushing pharmaceutical pills, and snorting them. And then later on, through more of the height of my addiction, I was smoking meth on the regular. And it didn't really matter what substance I was doing. Really, what I was trying to do was escape from my own head, escape from my past. And eventually that sort of got to the point where either I was going to end up dead or I was going to end up in prison.
Hi, my name is Richard, and I've been at Teen Challenge for 17 months.
The program's set up so that we're supposed to help each other. Like, the whole program is one person helping another to get through, right? So if somebody has questions, they can ask. There's one person who's kind of in charge of the kitchen, and that's their responsibility. So they can look up recipes, they can, kind of teach people, but like everybody gets a chance to go in the kitchen. Every 30 days the chores change, and then everybody gets a chance to try it, because when you leave here you have to kind of be responsible and learn how to do things for yourself, right? Some people come in here without any knowledge of how to cook or how to clean or all those like daily things. So this is an opportunity for people to learn and grow. By doing each of these chores and by helping each other, right, you're learning how to live, first of all, in community. Every day you make your bed, and every day you clean up after yourself. In the small things, they all add up. So in the big picture, right, so the, most likely if you're cleaning up your room and cleaning up yourself and daily hygiene, all those things, you're most likely not going to be depressed or want to go do something that's stupid. Take steps to better manage and better take care of yourself, then you learn how to better take care of others.
Now, being in the program in my 12 months here, I have been able to go out and get experience with construction, landscaping, demolition, basic yard work, working at the food bank, even just little things like that, doing VDP, which is our vehicle donation program, which actually allows us to pick up donated, cheap donated vehicles, basically bring them here and then fix them up. If they're worth fixing up, then we'll fix them up and then we'll sell them. And the funds from that go into funding our center here. At first, when you get to that phase of going out to work all the time, it tends to be a little bit daunting. The idea of going out to work all the time for basically for free, but it helps. It helps to, for me, for example, I'm working for other people. Now I'm working to help. I'm working for God, you know, and it helps your mental state, really, is what it does. The class time can be a little bit mundane, but it's designed to get you into an environment of learning about the Bible, about Christ, about addiction. What I love the most to think about the Teen Challenge schedule as it is right now is the free time to be able to come out to Love Rains, or to just kind of relax, and also the time that we have in the group session with Norm and Joanne when we have our group counseling session. I really treasure those times. It's a lot of very relaxing, but it's also challenging at the same time. It gives you time to really focus and meditate on things that you've learned throughout the week. And
I've had people cry when they get close to a horse because they were so afraid, it was so big, and then they found out that the horse can be so gentle, even though it's so big and strong and very fast, yet a horse can be so gentle to us. Like, this guy's just being really sweet right now, and he is a very sweet horse. He's well trained, but his nature is very sweet. He's very trusting. And so they often, when people discover that, especially children and hurt people, the biggest thing is they find the horse accepting. They find the horse doesn't have conditions except that they're approached with respect. The horse likes to be respected. He likes to be feel like he's safe with us. And we just meet those conditions, and the horse is very, very accepting of everybody.
When I begin to sort of model in my life towards Christ and surrender my own will to what he has taught, the more I receive a sort of godlike support in myself to be able to confront different challenges in my addiction. Like when I was talking about healing from past trauma, that whole process was actually guided by experiences with Christ in a very close inner healing kind of a setting. And that has really allowed in a supernatural way for me to be able to not only confront these different things that happen, but also receive healing, and to know that no matter what I do, no matter what I have done in the past or what I will do in the future, God still loves me.
Basically is respond to God, trust him, know that he won't hurt us, and that he loves us unconditionally.